Hi, I'm Todd Baginski. I'm a Microsoft MVP and the partner and CTO at Canvas. In this PowerApps video, I'm going to show you how you can use the Concurrent function to load data more quickly inside of your PowerApps application and improve a PowerApps app performance. Let's get started. To demonstrate this concept, I created a simple PowerApp so we can see what it looks like when we use the Concurrent function or when we don't use it and how that affects our app performance. You can learn more about the Concurrent function in PowerApps by coming to this page in docs.microsoft.com. Just do a search for Concurrent function in PowerApps. This describes everything that I'm talking about and demonstrating inside of this video. All right, so let's take a look at the sample PowerApp I made that demonstrates this concept. As you can see in my Power App here, I've got two different buttons. This one at the top will query all of my data sources in a sequential fashion. The code looks like this. Here you can see I set a variable for the start time equal to right now, and I format it to include the seconds, hours, minutes, year, month, and day. Then I create a new collection called Custom List Items. This collection, as well as many of the other collections inside of this Power App, are coming from SharePoint lists. If I look at the data sources in this app, you can see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different SharePoint lists. I'm also using the Office 365 Users connector. I'm using the OneNote for Business connector and the Planner connector. The data you see inside of the dotted line box in the middle of my Power App here shows you the data that I'm returning from each of these connectors. So if we take a look at the button again here, now we can see here's the different connectors for SharePoint at the top. Here's the Office 365 connector. In this case, I'm only returning unread emails. Actually, I'm returning only read emails because I say fetch only unread is false. I'm returning all the access accessible notebooks that I have from OneNote, and then all the different plans in Planner. Finally, at the very end, I create a new variable called MyProfile by calling into the Office 365 Users connector and returning the display name from the currently logged in user account. Then at the end, I set the end date to the time that's now so I can see when it started and when it finished. When I run that, I can then see the total elapsed time, which I'm basically subtracting the start time and the end time to see how long that operation took. Then I emit the count of all these different items here in my text box. And I also put out the MyProfile variable, which is the currently logged in user's display name. So in this approach, with the sequential calls here, notice I'm using the semicolon after every single call, and there's no mention of the concurrent function. I put the exact same button down here at the bottom. I'm calling the exact same data sources, but here I've wrapped all my calls to get data from data sources outside of the Power App inside concurrent. When you do this, every single one of these calls is going to happen at the same time instead of in sequential order, like in the button at the top of the page. Notice there's a comma here now instead of the semicolon. You separate the different calls that you're making inside of concurrent with a comma instead of a semicolon. You also notice the very last one you use does not require a comma. So now I've loaded up the Power App two times. I've got it open in two different web browsers so that there's no caching or anything that occurs here. In fact, I'll refresh both of them right now to make sure I'm working with a fresh copy. So let's start by clicking the button to query our data sources in a sequential fashion. Notice as I do it, as each data source call is completed, the number of items returned appears inside of the list, and it just goes top to bottom as each different query executes in a sequential fashion. So we can see that this took roughly 17 seconds to accomplish all of these calls. Let's go over to the one on the right now and run them concurrently. Here we can see that it only took 1 second to do all of those calls in a row. So the results are going to vary a little bit. In fact, the 17 seconds is the longest I've ever seen this take. And the 1 second for the concurrent calls is the shortest I've ever seen it take as well. So that's a good example. I'm going to refresh both again and run it one more time to show you there is a difference, but sometimes that difference is not as large as 16 seconds. So here we took 4,000 milliseconds or 4 seconds to do the operation. And now back to the right, 1 second. That's typically what I've seen from these particular data source calls. You'll also notice how many different items are coming back in the queries. These two different list item calls come from two different SharePoint subsites. It's the exact same list schema. It's I put 403 columns into one, and I actually have more than 500 in the other. So why is it showing only 500 here? If I open up the app settings for my Power App and go to advanced settings, you can see the data row limit for non-delegable queries at the top. It's set to 500. That's why I only saw 500, even though I have slightly more than 500 items in that particular list. If I up this threshold value here, and then I come back to my Power App, now, when I execute the query inside of the Power App, I'll see this number is actually 506, which is the total amount of list items that I had there. In either case, whether you're turning that limit up or down, using the concurrent function to allow you to make calls concurrently, just like we see here inside of the code in the Power App, is really going to improve your Power App performance. I hope this simple trick with Power Apps comes in handy for you and makes your Power Apps more performant. I hope you found this video helpful and helps you out as you develop your Power Apps. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel as I have many more Power Apps videos on the way. Have a good one.